that I can do a good budget. Like, how many rounds should I chant, 32 rounds of what? I said, you don't realize, Raghavendra Bhakti is lakhs times harder than Raghavendra Bhakti. It's not just the easy one, I think it is, to get there. So, I was just trying to make conversation with him, have some sambandha with him. So I showed him some slides of some paintings that I did for Prabhupada, for his Bhaktivedanta Book Trust books. And so then, he was looking at the slides, then he went to his Elmira, pulled out a Chaitanya Charitamrita, flipped through the pages, and he turned to one page of a painting that I had done of Radha and Krishna splashing in Radhakund with all the gopis there, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was standing on the shore watching. So he said, did you do this? He said, yeah, I did that. And he said, come here. And he took me into the next room. He said, can you paint my heart? And he took me into the next room where there was a picture of the Sevakunj painting.
That picture.
Yeah, this painting, but done by some Indian in Mathura. He said, I gave 3,000 rupees to have that person paint this picture. And I'm not at all satisfied. They both look too old. For example, he said, can you fix the faces? I said, well, I can fix the faces, but then the rest of it will look different. So he said, can you just make a whole new painting? And that's how it started. Then I started showing him small sketches, and he would say, this is too American, this is too, the face is too round, and it's like a deity. And so he started guiding me. And so I would show him the sketch again and again, then the colored sketch, and then the painting, I would bring it to him. I was in Vrindavan, and he was in Mathura a lot of the time. So I would, you know the temples, not temple, the auto rickshaws? I would put the painting either on top, hanging over the edges of the auto rickshaw, or sticking out the side, sitting next to me. And then I would bring it every few days, and Gurudev would give more and more directions, how to decorate her hair, what color Krishna's shirt should be, what Krishna's thinking, the kilakinchi dabas that they were both experiencing of contradictory moods. Although contradictory, they were worked harmoniously together, like Radharani smiling, weeping, playing hard to get at the same time flirting, Krishna's weeping in shame and at the same time smiling and begging. So that was the first one to say the cringe.
I think you
were
talking about Prabhupada also.
What?
The painting for Prabhupada.
She did not.
And how long did it take?
That one was the longest one that I ever took, since before or since after. That one took about 5 months. And I asked Gurudev, how come it took so long? And I wasn't just slacking off. I was working like sometimes 14, 15, 16 hours a day. But still, it wouldn't come until it wanted to come. And the time it came, I mean, first everything just looked like paint. It didn't look like real people. And every time I made Krishna's face, I would step back. And the next morning, come in again and look at it again. It's completely wrong. Everything is in the wrong place. I'd have to change everything. So nothing was working, although I was already now 4 months down the line. And then one day Gurudev called me from Vrindavan to Mathura, and he told me, I want you to add some kinkaris, some maidservants in the shadows. Not too many that it looks heebie-jeebie. You know heebie-jeebie? I just clutched on it. But make them all comfortably fit. And as soon as I painted them, everything else came in to show that by their mercy only can things happen. So anyway, so when the painting was finished, I asked Gurudev, how come this painting took so long? So he said, because I had to push my will through your will. That's why it took so long. I was so resistant.
thank you so much.
So I hope you all enjoyed